Hi, this is Rob with Eco Panels of Tennessee. And so today I want to talk a little bit about, you're getting prepared to assemble your panels. We've made them here at the shop. We're delivering them here pretty soon. And you're trying to figure out, okay, so what tools do I need? So first of all, I do want to invite you to request our assembly manual, whether your delivery's coming up or not. We'd be glad to share that with you. And that'll have a lot of instructions on how everything goes together. So, but I get a lot of questions. Well, what kind of tools do I need? Well, the first tool you're gonna need is something to unload our truck with. We do not bring an unloader. You do not wanna unload these by hand. Ideally, you would rent an all-terrain lull or all-terrain forklift. Those are available from rental places. That way you can take the panels off the truck and ideally just set them right up on the deck, on the subfloor or on the slab that you're building on. And that way they'll be ready to start putting up. Now, if you're within a certain range of our plant and ask us about this, we'll be glad to be there. I'll come out once somebody with our company will be out and we'll be there to help guide you. Now, if you're far, far away and that's not practical for us to be there, I've done a lot of assistance with setups on the phone, FaceTime, things like that. Technology now allows you to be somewhere without actually being somewhere. So those things are possible too. I guess the most important thing I want you to get out of that is we're not just gonna deliver it and then drive off and say good luck. We wanna help you see this through. So what are some of the things you need? So are there any kind of special tools? Well, no. A lot of people say, well, do I need a crane to put these panels up? With our panels, no. Average panel, like a wall panel, is gonna be 120 to 150 pounds, depending on whether it's a corner and how tall it is. So two people who have a better back than mine can handle that without any problem. No really special lifting mechanism required. If you got a third person that can help, that's good too. But you can move them around by hand. They stand them up and hook them together. So a couple things. String. So I'm kind of old school. I'm of the opinion that you can't build a house without string. This would be to make sure that when you lay out your sill plates that are gonna go at the bottom that the panels are gonna attach to, those are laid out straight. Make sure they're the right length with a tape measure. Tape measure, a very essential tool in building any house and certainly with ours. The cam lock key we actually send with the package. So we're gonna give you this one. This is the key to your house. This will be used to activate the cam locks to attach the panels together. And we have that detailed in another video that you can find on our channel. Level, super important. As we're putting up the panel walls, we want to make sure that everything is going straight before those are attached. So I like to check levelness on pretty much every panel just to make sure, because if you get off a little bit, it's just going to get worse. So use the level, use it a lot. By and large, obviously side to side, they're going to fit just fine, but in and out, we want to make sure that we're running true as your house goes together. I like to have a framing square with me just in case I need to check to see if our corners, not the panel corner, I know they're 90 degrees, but sometimes foundation corners are not 90 degrees. And so that'll allow us to double check that and make adjustments as needed. Otherwise, just a regular skill saw or circular saw is something that you would need. In case we get to the cheater corner piece, that's the one joint in each wall that does not have a cam lock that allows you to make adjustments. We would love to say that the foundation and subfloors are always the right size, but we can't say that because that would be a lie. They're always off a little. And so in our system, it's designed to have a place to make that adjustment in each long wall. And we can tell you more about that. And of course, that's detailed in our assembly manual. Bottom line, what I'd like you to kind of get out of this little video is there's not any special tools, just common things that you might have already or things that are readily available at the hardware store. No specialized things required. It's really pretty easy to put together. And Again, I want to invite you to request our free assembly manual. It goes over a lot of these details, and certainly call us, text us. If you have any kind of questions, our number one goal is for this thing to go up easy peasy when it gets to your place. We want everything to go smooth like butter. Typically, you know, average size house, I was at a setup not long ago. It was a 30 by 60 ranch style house. It was me, and I didn't pick up any panels because my back hurts. There was two guys and another guy. I'd say probably four people there working, plus me. I had all those panels up in about 4.5 hours on that house. And they had never seen a panel before I got there. I mean, this was like their first time ever. And after about 4 or 5 panels in, we were getting it done. We'd like to talk to you about your project and kind of go over some of these details with you. We invite you to contact us anytime. Shoot me an email, give us a call, text us. We'd love to hear about what you have in mind for your next home.